people. Again, I'm here. My knees are going to be slightly bent. My hands are here. When I go down, I want to make sure I'm landing on my forearms, not my wrists. Okay, I'm not doing like a push-up position. Landing right there. When I hit, I'm going to go, hey! Right? Just that's tightening up the body for just that moment of impact. Okay, so here I am here. I'm going to bend my knees. I'm not, I don't need to be up here falling, like so. I'm going to bend my knees, come through, hey! Okay, my shoulders are behind, my elbows are behind my shoulders. My palms are down, my head's turned to the side. Okay, so one more time. This time you guys can go with me. Okay, so my hands are up, my knees are bent. I'll lean forward just a little bit. Now I'm gonna head forward. Hey, hey, hey! Very good. Okay? All right, so our next one's back fall. Okay, and as I was saying, I don't want my arms out here. I'm not catching myself when I go back. My arms are crossed. Okay, I'm gonna squat down, and I'm gonna tuck my chin so I'm not hitting the back of my head when I land. So I'm here, I'm gonna roll back. Both hands come out, slap the mat. And then I also like to practice getting up, right? When we come up forward, when we're standing up, I practice this along with the poles. My hands are up. I'm going to tuck this knee, or tuck this foot, right inside here. I'm going to come out to this knee. A lot of times people try to go this way and they can't get back up. If you come out towards your knee, I can come knee, and then come up without using my hands. Okay, so make sure you're not too close to the wall. Start into here. This one we do together. So I'm going to squat down, tuck my chin, roll back. Okay, and then I'm going to sit up to here, I'm going to come out to the knee, and then the foot, and up. Alright, good. I'm going to start right hand on my forehead, and I'll put the left hand on my forehead, left foot forward. Okay, I'm going to kick the right foot forward, right? I'm going to let myself down. When my hip hits, I'm going to roll back. As soon as my hip hits, I slap my hand. Hey! Now feet and hips up, and then I roll it back out. Okay, so same arm bent, same leg bent. And I'm on my side. I'm not laying flat on my back, I'm landing on my side. Okay, now, I get up a little bit differently when we're practicing side pull. We're gonna go shoulder, we're gonna go to elbow, to the hand. This hand is gonna stay up. I'm gonna press my hips up. And I'm going to pull my foot back and stand up. Okay? So this time I'm going to do the other side. I'm going to go right foot forward, right hand up. Get everybody started. Okay, we're going to kick the left leg out. I'm going to go down, slap the mat when your butt hits. Hey! Feet and hips up in the air. Rolling that ball out over as much surface area as possible. All right, once we're to this position, we're going to roll elbow, hand, lift, bring the foot back, and all the way up. Okay. With rolling break fall, I got my right foot forward. I'm going to make a wheel with my hands. And I'm going to set that wheel right down by my front foot. Now, it's important that I'm looking on the outside of my arms, right? I see a lot of people do these where they put the hands down and they look between their arms. The problem with that is when I get to here and I begin to roll, boom, the head is the first thing to hit. So if I'll take my hands here, I look on the outside of my arms. Now when I roll, I'm rolling across here, I've got elbow, shoulder, hey! And then I'm going to land in the same position that I had landed in when I was doing the side pull, and I'm going to get up the same. I'm going to go elbow, hand, lift, pull the foot back, so I've got a triangle here, and up. Okay, so doing one together, right foot is forward, make a wheel with the hand, set that wheel beside the front foot, keep the back leg straight as you roll, elbow, shoulder, over, back, hey! And then when we're getting pull back, and up.